excitement, but then also some nervousness in the sense of like, all right, now we got to move forward.
A license to sell medical marijuana isn't in Shane Lynn's hands just yet. But now that the state's given his new business venture approval,
we got to put everything in place and make the phone calls and make sure that everything's funded and put together a business that's going to hopefully be really beneficial to a lot of people in this community.
Lynn is finalizing the location for the Champlain Valley Dispensary. He hopes to be open at one of these storefronts at Main Street Landing.
It is a little sketchy at night because it's pretty dark in the parking garage.
Kyle Wood is a manager at nearby Madera's. His shift ends late at night, and he admits he's a little worried about the dispensary and safety.
I feel like if they're gonna go rob that place, they're not necessarily gonna be looking for me. But, I mean, yeah, it does. It's always a thought in the back of your head.
Lynn maintains he's got security in mind.
Surveillance will be 24-hour coverage, there'll be two people working at a time.
Part of his next step, he says, is convincing people of the good he says a downtown dispensary can do.
It's a real-life, experience, and it changes how people live.
The other approved dispensary hopes to be in Waterbury. It will go by the name Patients First Incorporated. State officials tell News Channel 5 two more dispensaries could be approved in the next few months. In Burlington, Lauren Victory, News Channel 5.